So if you follow my Twitter and Instagram, know that I've been house hunting for the past couple of months, and between work and house hunting on the weekends, I haven't really had a lot of time to make videos or do much cosplay or anything like that either. But now that I bought the house, I'm starting to get settled, I'm painting, I've been decorating. It's time to start working on where I'm gonna start making videos again. I'm gonna do a little bit in the garage, but that's just gonna be a temporary space. I have a little kind of shed barn thing on the property. It needs to be kind of completely redone, so it's gonna be maybe 6 months before that's finished, maybe a year. So we're gonna be in the garage until that happens, but I'm gonna show you the garage, show you kind of some of the stuff I wanna do in there. So then I'm gonna take you to the shed slash workshop kind of space and kind of give you an overview of all the stuff that needs to be done there. So one thing about the garage is it has 15 or so, maybe 16 foot ceilings. And one thing is that landing there is about 4 feet up. So I'm thinking about using that height to create a 4 foot wide platform where I can put shelving on it and have about a 2 foot walk space slash workspace. And I think that'll free up a ton of space in the garage. So one thing is with the garage door, it's about 7, maybe 8 feet tall, and the railings on the side are at that same height. So it's kind of dead space above it. So I'm really looking at maybe getting those railings moved up to the ceiling and maybe do a wall mount door opener or something like that. I'm kind of up in the air. I think I've got to talk to a garage door expert and see what they suggest. So another thing I want to look at is getting the garage door insulated. So right now, everything else in the garage is finished and it's all insulated. So that's the only spot for the heat transfer. So with Georgia's hot summers and coldish winters, having that insulated would be a big help for having this be a place to store stuff like resins and things like that that are kind of temperature sensitive. So one thing I also want to use the garage for, besides getting the shelves done and start storing crafting supplies in there, is I do want to put a squat rack in there and kind of get a home gym set up. I'm kind of sick of paying for a gym and kind of being regulated on hours and stuff like that. I love to just go after work, work out for a little bit, and then shower and go to bed or something like that, or get up early in the morning and take care of it. So that's a goal I have. That's also one of the main reasons why I want to adjust the garage door, is so I can have space for a larger squat rack. So let me take you outside, show you what the outside of the current shed workshop looks like, how it looks on the inside, and then I'll give you some ideas on what I want to do with it. So here's the kind of shed slash workshop. So I'm going to take you inside and kind of show you around a little bit, but I don't know if you can see it, but the roof is kind of, especially on this overhang here over the window, it's kind of all rotted out and needs to be replaced. So this is the kind of shed workshop I was talking about. So like the beams are telephone poles. So they should be pretty sturdy. I mean, they don't wiggle or nothing like that. So I feel like they're fully embedded in the ground. The walls are slatted. And it's kind of like a hodgepodge of different stuff at different times. The concrete itself is not level in any way. It looks like it's been done by, it was definitely amateurly done. But like some of it's somewhat level, some of it appears to be like just slopped in at some point. One of the main things is the roof, which is metal, is decent, but the beams for the roof are 2x6. It's got 1x3 slats over that. There's spray foam, there's silicone filling up old nail holes because they just reuse the metal. So I think it's gonna have to be a pull off and redo at some point. And then over here on this side, you just got a slatted wall with some fine chicken wire on it. So this is a slat wall that needs to be redone. So I wanna do full sheeting and then maybe throw the slats back up. So the window looks really nice. It was put in wrong. The outside's on the inside for some reason. The windows I like, I wanna save them. There's actually a pile of windows that I guess from the remodel that were left outside. So I want to kind of see how those look, see if they're, how well they hold up, and use those in here as well. So there's some work that needs to be done, but I think it can be a solid space. One thing about the roof as well is it starts about maybe 6 feet, maybe 6.5 feet, and then goes to about maybe 10 feet tall. So that's not bad. I would like it taller, but with the structure the way it is, I'll probably just leave it and then maybe expand out later on down the line. Getting this place functional, getting it power, maybe a little bit of water, and an AC unit is definitely a must, especially in Georgia in the summer. So I'm probably thinking a split unit for that. So that's kind of a rough overview of the place, where the craft room is gonna be temporarily, and where I want it to be permanently, kind of in 6 months to a year time frame. Hopefully you join me on that adventure, and I'll see you next time.